Two of the best tools that you can get for fault finding is a multimeter. Now this is a marvellous piece of kit for doing many things, and there's plenty of tutorials on YouTube on how to use it and things like that. And this one, I used to have one of these in the UK. It was an RCD tester and socket, and it tells you if you're earth and you're neutral or mixed ground, or whether you're live. It tells you every combination, and it's got a set of lights on there as to if the first two lights are on like it was in the socket, it means everything is okay. So there you go, get them two pieces. I think 280 baht and I think about 400 or 500 baht for a good meter. So finding this problem out as to why the electricity is fluctuating. So now we've got to do a few tests. So using one of the pieces of equipment that I said you should use is a multimeter. And what we're going to do, we're going to test the income from there. Now this goes all the way over to the meter on the other side of the road. So we need to see what type of voltage is coming in there. So by putting them on the income and then looking at the multimeter, and it shows there's 229 volts. Now yesterday, when we had the electrical problem, it was showing 185, and then eventually it was fluctuating down to zero, up to 185. It was going all over the place. So that's the way to check to see whether what voltage it is. The other way to test is get one of these little devices. Now these are brilliant because these measure the voltage in it. This one here has got even a little RCD tester, so you can check to see whether your RCD works. So once we plug that in, again, that's showing us that everything is okay. The two little lights, it's got a little denote on there, so what the lights are going to be. And basically, if you want to test your RCD to see whether it works, you just press this little button and there it goes off. That tests your RCD to make sure that it's working. It's a brilliant piece of kit. And so this is where it's done. It's switched off the RCD. So if you have any faults in your house whatsoever, it trips the RCD. So all you need to do then, you just flick it back up and everything's working again. So again, if you did have a problem on one of the fuses, what I suggest you do is just turn everything off, turn the RCD back on, and then gradually switch one back up, and if your RCD trips, it's on whichever circuit that you lifted up. This is the fault finding part of it. Now before I fitted this, we used to have an old isolator switch. I wiggled the neutral wire and the voltage was going all over the place, and the last time we had a fault, so I assumed it could be a problem with the main switch. So I changed the main switch and I put the RCD protection, which covers everything in there, which is much safer than what it was. So all the electrics has gone off on the house again. This is the second time it's gone off. And when the electricity board came round the last time, everything was working. But this time we've seen some sparks on the wires and the electricity boards come out. And it was quite quick, only 35 minutes. But that's the advantage of having solar. We've got solar on, all the lights are on the outside. Now the last time it was shorting out, it took 3 hours for the electric board to come and have a lock. And Sod's Law, as he turned up, the short sort of stopped, and he did his measurements and he couldn't see any fault with it. But basically, there's our meter. And the cables go up there. Now I suspected a fault on there somewhere, but at the time he did his measurements, and that's another place where you do your measurements, and I'll show you how I did that measurement when it was a fault again. But basically what he says, the electricity board are responsible for the electric going into that, and then after that it's our cable, and if our cable's faulty then we have to replace it. So he suggested that we could have a fault on our cable because it wasn't working. And that's an expensive repair because our cable goes underground. And what we would have to do is run a new cable from the meter over the road, down the post. And as our cables come down there and it goes into the ground somewhere, so where it goes from there over to the house, I wouldn't like to hazard a guess. We'd have to renew the cable all the way from the house, and we'd have to run it externally because I'm not going to dig up the ground, run to that post and then down the meter. And I roughly worked it out for 16 millimeter cable for that type of distance was 12 to 14,000 baht plus somebody to do it, because I wouldn't be able to get up that height and run it. So you're talking of 15 or 20,000 baht, I would have thought. So I thought that was a bit of an expense. And then for a few weeks, we've never had the problem until yesterday. Then the problem happened again, and I could see it was sparking over there. So I knew exactly the fault that I thought it was going to have before. And thankfully, the guys arrived 30 minutes after we called them, and we told them, and I had it on my video as to what it was and the spark, and the voltage reading was only 185 volts. So half an hour later, they put a new cable on, and Bob's your uncle, everything is fixed. So if you've had this type of problem, that's the stages that I'd suggest that you go through, and take video evidence of it, what was happening. I mean, as you've seen at the beginning of this video, our lights were flashing on and on. So it was obvious there was something wrong. I like fault finding, and I was happy that it was the original fault that I thought it was, and that was for the main line fault and it wasn't our cable. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you don't like it, give it a thumbs down. Leave your comments down below, and I hope this video was helpful. Thanks very much for watching.